Our top story tonight is the radical overhaul of Australia's newspapers, which will cost thousands of jobs. Eddie Meyer is outside Fairfax's Sydney headquarters. Eddie, how are staff dealing with this shock announcement?
Well, Hermione, behind me, staff are putting the final touches, the finishing touches, on tomorrow's edition of the Sydney Morning Herald. Little did they know as today began that they would be the major news story in town, and the news they have to digest has been a terrible shock. 1,900 of them will lose their jobs in the next 3 years. Their beloved paper will move from a broadsheet to a tabloid. Printing presses will close. It is a major overhaul, all aimed at trying to save this business. Now, it doesn't end there, because tomorrow there will be possibly a boardroom showdown. Gina Rinehart, Australia's richest woman, the world's richest woman, has now lifted her stake in Fairfax to 19%, and she's demanding three board positions, including one for herself as deputy chairman. She also wants the right to hire and fire editors and have more editorial control. This is far from over, Hermione.
Absolutely. Eddie Meyer, thank you for the update. And Hamish will have more on tonight's top story shortly. Two children are in the care of relatives tonight after their parents were charged with killing a security guard at one of Sydney's busiest shopping malls. 69-year-old Hans Schultz was set upon by a man and a woman after they broke into an ice cream kiosk at Broadway Shopping Centre. Police say the woman's young children were with them at the time.
It's certainly a tragic event when a man goes to work, gets involved in an assault and dies, and it just compounds that when there are a five-year-old and a three-year-old child present at the scene.
The pair has been charged with manslaughter. Same-sex marriage supporters have delayed a final vote in federal parliament in a bid to shore up numbers. An inquiry into two bills for change has seen strong community support with a record number of submissions. It comes as churches ramp up their opposition.
5 million Catholics in Australia don't all necessarily speak with the one voice of Archbishop Pell, that's for sure.
There's little chance the bills will succeed, with coalition MPs denied a conscience vote. Under controversial new laws to tackle truancy, parents of children who repeatedly wag will be fined. Reporter Alicia Morrison joins us live with the details from Melbourne. Alicia, how do parents feel about these changes?
Well, this latest Victorian government crackdown on repeat waggers has certainly managed to divide opinion here today. Under the proposed changes by the government, it would see the parents of repeat offenders liable to pay even bigger fines. They're currently fined around $120 by the court, but the Education Department is yet to reveal the detail of the new law, so we don't know exactly how many days off would mean they would incur a fine and exactly how much money that would be. But certainly the parents we spoke to today were understandably pretty critical about this radical idea.
Maybe parents need to be made more accountable for children missing school.
And parents need to look after their kids, do the right thing, but what's the point of punishing people? It doesn't make any sense.
We lived in the UK for a while and they had a very strong truancy policy there. And I found it a little bit inhibitive, because sometimes you want to take them out to actually go on holiday.
And the Education Department here has, of course, called on the government to at least come to them first and have a discussion before this radical plan is implemented. Hermione.
Thanks, Alicia Morrison in Melbourne. The search for two men missing off the New South Wales central coast will be scaled back tomorrow. The body of an 18-year-old woman who was fishing with the pair was found yesterday, but her friends remain unaccounted for. Meanwhile, rough seas are hampering efforts to find two other men aged in their 60s after their yacht was discovered off a remote Pacific island. Another three Indonesians convicted of people smuggling are on their way home after claiming they were minors at the time they were apprehended. Their cases were reviewed after the high-profile case of Ali Jasmine, who was released and sent home last month. Attorney General Nicola Roxon says new information has now come to light, leading to the further releases. More cases are being reviewed. Fans of the Rolling Stones will be desperately hoping it's not true, but word is the band is calling it quits after 50 years in the business. It's believed the famous rockers will play a farewell gig at next year's Glastonbury Festival. Sources say they'll also play a handful of shows across the UK and America. Now in their 60s and 70s, the four-group member believe the time is right to finish up. A quick look at the weather across the country tonight. It's currently 11 degrees in Sydney, 13 in Melbourne, 10 in Brisbane, 13 degrees in Adelaide, 15 in Perth and 24 in Darwin. I'll have tomorrow's forecast a little later on.